No importation, no sale, no use of Maida chloroprint, because we want to protect our bee farmers, and we want to thank the bee farmers, Beekeepers Association, for bringing this matter up to us, and we want to thank you all for your cooperation, and we are looking forward to informing customs that 1st of January, no more importation of bees, and of course, no more sale. Get your attention to the issue of paraquat. All of you are aware, for the last two decades actually, a lot of people have raised this issue, members of the community, about the toxicity of paraquat. Now, but that's another dimension, and you might say that, you know, that's not our concern, that's the concern of health ministry, etc. But I want to bring to your attention that members of the public has been writing to us, have raised this matter for long. You also would have seen letter to editors that, you know, their concern about over-the-counter sale of paraquat and those which is those chemical which has this active ingredient of paraquat, which is glimepiride, argazone, that how toxic it is and how people have abused it. But our concern was the negative impact of this particular pesticide, weedicide, on agriculture itself, on the environment. We have found that it has a major effect on users of this. Those farmers, quite a number of them here, I've used it when I was, you know, doing farming when I was young, when we were spraying, how this chemical would splash out of the knapsack sprayer. You know, I've used it myself, and it splashes out, and then in the evening you'll see that, you know, you'll start scratching your skin. Now it has been found that it has short-term health effects on where it contacts your body, includes eye injury, nosebleeds, irritation, burns the skin. But in the longer run, that if you are by mistakenly, if you are able to inhale that, or if you consume small bits of it, even though it's a small concentration, it can have a disastrous effect on your health in the longer run. But because it takes a long period of time to really see the impact on your health, people haven't been taking this seriously. WHO has classified this as a class 2 toxicity level, class 2, but some researchers, some scientists argue that it should be classed as number 1 in terms of toxicity. Very toxic, this particular chemical.